Hi there, I'm Darren McDermott and you're watching Targets in Focus. I'm joined by Wolfgang Ernst at Raiffeisen Bank in Vienna to have a look at the Polish zloty, Hungarian forint and Czech korona. So let's begin with the zloty. Many are expecting the Polish zloty to be leading currency gains in the Central and Eastern European markets next year. But at the moment, it is actually trading quite flat. So why is this and how do you see it trading over the coming months?
Main reasons why the Polish zloty currently is moving rather flat. Well, it has two reasons. One is tapering fears, obviously, continuing. Second is, in our view, coincides with moves on the bond market. We've seen a rise in yields on the Polish market, partially to expectations of a possible interest rate hike already in 2014. And the zloty is basically moving along with the yield, or it has been moving on with the yields for the past couple of weeks and months. And therefore, we've seen a flat Polish zloty at the moment. And nevertheless, going into 2014, we are fairly optimistic regarding the economic outlook in Poland, and thereby also the Polish zloty should then, in the course of 2014, witness some appreciation trend against the euro. Nevertheless, in our view, in the first half of 2014, this appreciation trend is probably going to remain a bit subdued. On a one-month horizon, we only expect the zloty to remain flat at about 4.2 against the euro. On a six-month horizon, we expect some moderate appreciation going into the direction of 4.15. And then in the second half of 2014, we're a bit more optimistic for the zloty and expect it to end the year at 4.0.
And looking at the Hungarian forint, the Budapest Stock Exchange and the forint both had a bad month in November. The central bank has taken an aggressive attitude in terms of cuts. So tell us about the trading trends we are seeing and what you expect to see.
Yes, basically we've seen in the Hungarian forint more or less a sideways movement in the last months. It's been remarkably stable when you look at the interest rate reductions that were fairly aggressive in recent months. And we expect those interest rate reductions to continue into the first quarter of 2014, ending in our estimation probably around the level of 2.8%. But here the risk is to, in our view, more to the downside that they will continue even with more aggressive interest rate cuts, as long as the Hungarian forint remains stable and inflation rate obviously is supportive. Nevertheless, in the overall view for 2014, we expect the sideways movement of the Hungarian forint to continue. And we have to keep in mind that we expect some moderate improvement on the economic side as well. And our expectation is that the interest rate reductions will not be overdone. So we expect them to end at 2.8 and not continue onwards. So our expectation for the Hungarian forint is a more or less a sideways movement, probably in the range of 300 to 310 for the entire year.
And finally, the Czech koruna. How is this currency pair trading and what are the main driving factors?
The most recent driving factor for the Czech crown, in our view, were clearly the disappointing Q3 GDP figures. They have been the preliminary data has been finalized now. It was a bit better than the preliminary data. Nevertheless, the overall picture of economic growth in the Czech Republic isn't really reflected as we've seen in the leading indicators. So there was some disappointment regarding the economic development in the Czech Republic. And, of course, you must not forget that a member of the Polish Monetary Council also issued a statement regarding a possible increase of this intervention zone towards 28 to the euro. That, of course, was also not helpful. And those factors simply led to a bit of a weakening in the Czech crown towards 27.4, where we are currently. Nevertheless, for 2014, we also, as for other countries, expect the economic sentiment to pick up, the economic data to improve, until we see the 27 mark again for the Czech crown against the euro. in the course of 2014. Nevertheless, in the short term, in the one-month horizon, we think we will stay at the 27.4 level, given that we do not expect any GDP data that is going to support any stronger Czech crown in the short term. For the course of 2014, we expect the Czech crown then to appreciate towards this intervention level of the central bank of 27. And in our expectation, with a recovery in economic terms and with an increase of inflation rate that is probably going to hit its lows early in 2014, the central bank will have more room to maneuver to maybe already start to loosen this intervention at 27 in the second half of 2014. And our estimation currently is that we might see a move already to lower this intervention towards 26 at the end of 2014.
Wolfgang, thank you very much today. Well, viewers, do stay tuned as we have plenty more coming up. See you soon.